We are starting this video by remembering the Moto3 rider Jason Dupasquier, who we tragically lost on Sunday after he was involved in a multi-bike crash at the end of Q2 on Saturday. All our thoughts and prayers are with his family and friends and his entire team and everybody else in MotoGP community. The news hit us just as the Moto2 riders were getting away for the warm-up lap, so none of the Moto2 riders even knew about it until after the race was over. MotoGP, however, happened more than 1 hour after the news was released. Somewhere or the other, it affected the race for all the riders, a few more than the others. After the race, a few of the riders also mentioned that they didn't feel right going to race right after hearing the sad news. I also contemplated against making this video, but since they decided to go ahead with racing, I too decided to go ahead with the video. Let's round up the winners and losers of Italian GP. My name is Sankalp and this is your Racing News Fix. Let's start with the winners of Italian GP. The man in form, the championship leader, a renewed Fabio Quartararo, had a typical Lorenzo-esque runaway victory and without a doubt is the biggest winner of Italian GP. Right from FP4, Fabio looked in control of the race pace and he maximized his chances of getting the job done on Sunday by grabbing the pole on Saturday with a record-shattering lap around the Mugello circuit. He made a perfect start alongside two Ducatis and lost only one place by the time they reached turn 1, which in itself was impressive. More on that when we get to Yamaha in a minute. Next up, Joan Mir. Boy oh boy, did he prove why he is the reigning world champion. Starting from the bottom of the third row, Suzuki man had a great start and while he was stuck behind Ducati of Jack Miller for quite a while, eventually getting past him and making his way towards the podium places all the while fighting with his teammate was plain awesome. More on his teammate a bit later. On Thursday, Mir did say that he was inspired by Rins's P4 in 2019 and seriously, did he use the inspiration to the maximum or what? On to Miguel Oliveira, Brad Binder and KTM. KTM have had a poor start of the season and they look to be in trouble right from Qatar test. Their problems have been mainly attributed to the tyre allocation this year. Check out this video in the top right corner for more on that. The Austrian factory brought a new chassis at Mugello and both factory RC16s were fast right from the get-go on Friday. Also, both the factory boys made it to Q2 directly. Miguel Oliveira made a great start by getting close to top 3 early on and did an amazing job staying there after Bagnaia crashed out and Zarco lost his tyres, and towards the end defended his P2 beautifully against the master of the late attacks, Joan Mir. Brad Binder also had a strong and consistent race and came home in P5 even after Marc Marquez ran into him, which deployed his airbags and made it difficult for him to keep up with those ahead of him. Next up, Yamaha. For 5 straight races, we have heard Fabio talking about how much they are losing at the start due to missing front hole shot device. And man, did the Yamaha factory deliver or what? Starting alongside two Ducatis, Fabio was able to keep the lead of the race initially and got overtaken only due to horsepower deficit and not due to the start from standstill. And while all the hype and a lot of media coverage is all around the red Ducatis and orange Hondas, Yamahas are silently doing the business and have won 4 out of 6 races so far and are leading all 3 championships. Next in the line of winners, Suzuki. Yes, one of their bikes ended up in the gravel again. But getting a podium on a track which has one of the longest straights of the calendar whilst having a serious top speed deficit is truly impressive and they have certainly done something right with that GSX-RR. A few honorary mentions who didn't quite make the list of winners were Joan Zarco. Top Ducati kept a sensible head and didn't take any unnecessary risk and came home in P4 and moved himself up to P2 in the championship standings. Aleix Espargaró. Unfortunately, his arm pump surgery didn't go as well as it did for Fabio and Miller and he was constantly retaining fluid in his arm throughout the weekend. Still coming home in P7 on a very very physical track was a very brave effort from the Spanish rider. Danilo Petrucci. Another top 10 despite not having updated chassis from KTM was a great result for the 2019 Mugello winner. Valentino Rossi. On what is being speculated as his last appearance on a MotoGP bike at Mugello, the Italian legend rode his way through to P10 after starting from the back of the grid in P19. Even though we didn't see it on TV, the doctor had a few battles with a few riders all the way through. And now, the losers of Italian GP. Alex Rins. The Suzuki man has now DNF'd 4 times in a row out of 6 races so far. He now sits in P13 in the championship, 82 points behind the leader and 42 points behind his own teammate. For most of the race, he was doing very well and at one point, it looked like they might even make it a double podium for Suzuki, but it all went down in the gravel trap at turn 15 with only 5 laps to go. Now, whether he used up all his front tire in getting past Ducatis of Jack Miller and Joan Zarco or not, it doesn't matter, because 0 points in 4 races is what makes you lose championships. What makes it worse, in my opinion, is that much like the Portugal crash, he says he doesn't know what he did wrong which led to the crash. Pecco Bagnaia. Leading the race from Fabio Quartararo, arguably Pecco was the only one on the grid yesterday who could have given Fabio some serious competition. But his race ended only after a lap and a half. With the first real mistake so far this season, Pecco has dropped down to P3 in the championship standings and the point deficit has grown from 1 to 26 points. Marc Marquez, Taka Nakagami, Alex Marquez and Honda. Things are not going Honda's way at the moment and the results are showing that race weekend after race weekend. Marc's return to racing has been a bit underwhelming and according to the 8-time world champion himself, his mind is asking him to do things his right shoulder cannot do at the moment. On the LCR side of things, both the riders have factory equipment and both of them have had some time on the RC213V. But what hurts them the most is the continuous crashes and a lack of consistency and in Alex's case, even a little bit of lack of pace. All four Honda riders are outside the top 10 in the championship standings and as a result, Honda are nowhere in the manufacturer and team championships as well. Maverick Vinales. When your less experienced teammate is running at the front, leading the races and the championships and you are stuck in Q1 because you crashed out in FP3 and let some rider get under your skin and destroy your quali session, it doesn't look good. After what looked like a stronger than ever start, Maverick Vinales has yet again faded into the darkness and dropped down to P6 in the championship, 41 points behind his teammate. Vinales needs a win now and he needs it desperately because if it keeps going on like this, I don't know how long Yamaha will wait before they start looking elsewhere. Ducati. Going from hoping to have an all-red podium to not having even a single Ducati on the podium and losing the lead in all three championships at an overhyped home race is definitely a bad day all the way around. A few names who almost made it to the losers but in the end didn't were Jack Miller. Coming on strong with 2 wins in a row, the Australian rider did not look strong at all. But looking at his past record at this venue, his target from the start was to see the checkered flag and haul in some decent points, which he did by coming home in a decent P6. Paul Espargaro. Even though he came home in a lousy P12, he was the top Honda. And from lap 4 or 5 onwards, his right wing just flew off the bike, which made his life difficult on the straights as well as on change in directions. If you made it till here, let me know by hitting the like button. For regular updates and insights about all things MotoGP, subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell. Here are 2 more videos which you might enjoy. My name is Sankalp and I'll be back with another video very soon.